Last time we tried delidding, the process of removing the heat spreader from a CPU, we decided that it wasn't really worth the effort, the voided warranty on a brand new $300 processor, or the risk. But it has since come to our attention that while X-Acto knives are a fun, if a little dangerous, tool for delidding, there is a much better way to go about it. So then, with the Durbauer delidding tools in hand for both LGA 1151 and 2066, that's right, my friends, we are gonna get naked with a Core i9. We are going to re-evaluate delidding. Should you do it? Synergy allows you to share your mouse and keyboard between multiple computers at once. Check it out now at the link in the video description. Now, both of Intel's current platforms are notorious for running pretty, hot, with many enthusiasts pointing to Intel's use of a paste rather than solder-based thermal interface material between the heat-producing die and the protective heat spreader over top of it. So, let's take a look at our tools. This guy right here is the... Oh man, it's gonna be such comment fodder. Okay, so this is the Durbauer D-Lid Mate 2. The tool itself, actually pretty straightforward. It's two metal pieces here and a hex wrench. So the CPU sits in the grooves here with the arrow pointing to... Wait a minute. Anthony, did you delid this already?
Yes.
The IHS isn't on right. It's 90 degrees off. Okay. Well, you know what? That's okay, because this is a good opportunity to show you guys how it works. So I'm gonna delid it again so we can put it back on properly. Pretty much, you slide this second piece in here, you tighten up this screw as much as you can by hand, you throw in the hex wrench, and bippity boppity boop. That's all there is to it. The hex screw pulls against the IHS with mechanical force, causing its silicone seal to break, and you have got yourself a delidded CPU. Then we just need to scrape off the silicone, clean that baby up, and oh, look how shiny it is! Okay, now, you could technically run a CPU like this with the cooler straight on the die. But with modern Intel processors, it's impractical for a couple of reasons, not the least of which is that in order to get good contact between your cooler and the CPU, you have to remove the retention mechanism, meaning there's no easy way to keep the CPU in the socket, etc., etc., etc. So, what most people are doing is they're taking their delidded processor, they're using a higher quality thermal compound, so we'll be using Thermal Grizzly, also provided by Durbauer, and they're pretty much gluing that sucker back together. So we're just gonna take some pretty generic silicone junk here that we pulled out of a tube in our caulking gun. We put it in a syringe and we're just gonna kinda, yeah, I'm not doing a very nice job of this, but whatever, you guys get the point. Okay, so that's on there. We take just a little bit of thermal compound. Then we take our CPU, we put it back in the delidding tool, aligning the triangle with the triangle, not triangle with the dot. And we take our IHS and we put that on, aligning the dot with the dot. Bippity boppity, close-ish. All right, then to make sure that our IHS is aligned correctly, we jam this baby in here and you take the included little turny, screwy, grippy doodad here. You tighten this baby down, right on the center. There we go. And then leave it for about half an hour to harden back on. Anyway though, delidding the 7700K, that's been done to death. That's the boring one. Good thing Anthony already has the performance numbers that demonstrate that as long as you're willing to give up your warranty, this safer way of delidding is a fantastic way to significantly drop your CPU temperatures, which is obviously a good thing. Wait, how did he get performance numbers on this if the IHS was on the wrong way? You know what? Forget it. I don't even want to know, because the main event today is the prototype Der Bauer delidding tool for X299. This one works a little differently, using the force from this lever right here to push the IHS. But the whole thing is still powered by a hex screw with one of these included Allen wrenches. So we're gonna be delidding the Core i9-7900X because we like to live dangerously. Get on in here, Dennis, come on. Get a look at this, man. So, we put the CPU in, aligning the triangle right there with the triangle right there. So that's all pretty straightforward so far. It sits in there nice and snug. All right, then, in theory, and I haven't read the instructions, we just do this. Look at this thing. Look at how like over, the thing is so German. You turn this thing and then it pushes this thing, which in turn pushes this thing, like, oh man. So over-engineered. I love everything about it. Okay, it's getting tight now. I'm getting tense. Oh, it's getting really tight now. Okay. Oh man, that's a lot of pressure. This is legitimately getting really hard to push. Oh, okay, this is tense. Oh my goodness. I think it's off. Okay, I think it's off. Okay. $1,000 processor, kids. Ladies and gentlemen, $1,000 chip. Oh. Oh, wow. Oh, there it goes. Holy crap. Look at the way that thing is assembled. It's got silicone sealant up the butt. Okay. Whew. Oh, baby. Hopefully this thing still works. Oh, I need my alcohol. This kind. So, same basic procedure. Let's clean her up. She's shiny, baby. Shiny. Now, apply our silicone again. Apply our thermal grizzly again, this time using the handy dandy applicator end. I'm trying to. Oh lordy. Oh, this is bad. Oh, that's way too much thermal compound. This is awful. Okay. That's it. I'm never gonna be a professional thermal compound applier. Oh, really? This time, get this, it's dot to triangle. So we go ahead and put that baby on there. We do not have an alignment tool this time, so we're just gonna have to YOLO it. Then we throw the whole thing back in the delidding tool and we clamp her down. That's right, we're giving her the clamps, baby. It should be fine. Everything's fine. Moment of truth time, my friends. Let's get this installed in the socket here. So again, triangle to triangle. Hopefully that orientation works just fine for us here. Cooler time. Here we'll just be using IC Diamond. Let's throw this baby on here. Where are my thumb screws be at? Beaches? Is it gonna post or what?
It just posted.
It did? Oh yeah, woo! Okay, so the CPU still works. That's good. So now all we gotta do is throw our overclock profile on and then we can do some temp results for you guys. What just happened? Well, that's not good.
This is better than it was.
Really?
Yeah, it was 105.
Oh no! Okay.
I mean, it's hitting that again, but not immediately like it did before.
Okay, so we just need to wait 10 minutes for our final result here. So here we are, and we can actually kind of wrap things up here. Our Core i7 managed a 17-degree delta at 4.8 gigahertz, allowing it to run at that speed for half an hour for a stress test with no throttling whatsoever. Cool. As for our Core i9, well, it looks like our overclock wasn't 100% stable. Our system actually crashed. But the good news is that while we were still running at super high temperatures, come on in here, we actually thermal throttled less than we did for our first run through before delidding. Okay, so it's actually a few days later, and what we saw with our overclocked result turned out to surprisingly be a result of the better cooling performance, even though the temperatures weren't that different. So if we look at the graphs, our Intel TIM overclock test was tripping thermal protection despite a very modest voltage bump of only 10 millivolts. So you can actually see it as it drops in the CPU load that's reported in Task Manager and also in the reported temps. With Thermal Grizzly Conductanaut, it actually stabilized, and then that was what revealed that our overclocked frequency wasn't stable. So since we can't put a number on that type of improvement, what we'll do is revert to comparing our stock cooling performance. And wouldn't you know it, we actually got 20 degrees lower on the maximum reported temperatures after delidding. 20 degrees! So it's crystal clear then that Intel's stock TIM is basically toothpaste by comparison. But should you void the warranty on your brand new $1,000 CPU? Well, given that this tool isn't even out yet, to say nothing of the mess of the silicone adhesive, that's a solid no, I think, for most people. But if you're looking to squeeze every last bit of performance out of your new workstation, and you don't mind the risks involved, well, there are definitely gains to be had. Big thanks to Synergy for sponsoring today's video. Synergy is the software download that solves a hardware problem. Having two keyboards and two mice, or heaven forbid, three keyboards and three mice for all the different computers that you're running at your battle station. You'll never have to confuse which one goes with which. And it is perfect for developers or gamers who also like to use a Mac for productivity because it is cross-platform. Windows, Mac, and Linux. You just share your keyboard and mouse across multiple computers, just moving the mouse between the screens seamlessly. It even has features like dragging and dropping files between the computers, the ability to set up hotkeys, and more. So use our link in the video description to get 50% off Synergy today. So thanks for watching, guys. If you disliked this video, you can hit that button. But if you liked it, hit like, get subscribed, maybe consider checking out where to buy the stuff we featured at the link in the video description. Buy processors, delidding tools, it's all there. Also down there is a link to our merch store where you can buy a cool shirt like this one and our community forum, which you should totally join.